Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, I am Tika Amanda. I am a delegation from Universitas Pendidikan Muhammadiyah Sorong in the Outstanding Student Selection Program in 2022. Now, I am going to discuss about one of the Sustainable Development Goals number 14 about life below water. Indonesia is an archipelago country where 70% of its territory is ocean. The current crisis of life below water because the effect of plastic waste is very crucial, which has a bad impact on the environment because the nature of plastic is difficult to decompose. In our daily activities, the using of plastic can accelerate the process of reducing oxygen, increase the killing of marine life, they make the digestive system of marine life, and it will be harmful for ourselves. The more plastic waste in the ocean, it will make the greater problem to the sustainability of life below water. The volume of trash in the ocean is also increasing rapidly. This condition makes the sea a vulnerable water area and faces very serious problem, as we know it before. The data from the Central Statistics Agency in 2021 said that Indonesia's plastic waste reached 66 million tons per year. Indonesia is also the second largest contributor to plastic waste in the ocean after China. According to data from the World Economic Forum in 2016, state that in 2025 there will be more plastic than fish in the ocean, and it dangerous for human life and fish. The government has issued on rule number 19-1999 on the control of marine destruction. The government regulates the mechanism for reducing marine pollution, including for formation of national coordination team for handling waste at sea, in accordance with its duties for and function. The Ministry of Maritime Affairs and Fisheries also participate in effort to handle several of ship accidents at sea that cause pollution at sea. Sustainable brands sound that its digest number 14 was almost generally considered the less important of all goals. Only 5% of survey participants put its digest number 14 into the 6 priority goals. In the end, the big threat to our marine ecosystem is not only from overfishing or the climate crisis. The Great Pacific Trash Patch on increased sea water discharge, habitat loss or illegal fishing industry. The main problem lies in our ignorance about our environment. Since 2015, West Papua has proclaimed itself to be a conservation province in Indonesia. This commitment is the province's first effort and work program implemented by the West Papua provincial government. Researcher from Mogabai state that in 2017, the Sorong City government reclaimed Tembok Berlin Beach to develop the area as a marine center. As a result, now the beach has turned into land. It's a shame how many marine biota have disappeared because of the reclamation. It is very sad, isn't it? The result of the study in that the industrial activity in Sorong City are causing pollution in the appearance, and the pollution category is classified into Class D, which is bad and heavy pollutant. Sorong has conservation area located in Makmun in Sorong Regency. It is supported by government SSN for 2021 Conservation Mobilization Community Group in South Sorong Regency, West Papua Province. The recently hands offer SSMs to maintain and preserve the wealth of marine and fishery resources in the local area. To support the conservation program set by the government, we from Uni Muda Sorong have participated in the Rethinking Plastic Circular Economy Solution to Marine Litter project significantly. This project works, among others, in the fields of plastic waste management, sustainable plastic consumption, production and reduction of waste from the ocean. It is co-funded by the European Union and the German Federal Ministry for Economic Cooperation and Development. Papua is known as a small paradise that fell to the earth. This little paradise must be fully cared attention, and preserve. Thank you.